Hey guys, MasterJ2001 here today, and I've got a brand new Blender tutorial for you guys today. And I'll be teaching you how to make the BioShock logo from the game BioShock. Now, it's not going to be an exact recreation, as I don't have the textures they used, and sadly, at the moment, in my skill set, I don't know how to have the water drizzle over the front of the logo. So, put those two things aside, we will still make a very, very cool looking BioShock logo. As we'll be following the two key principles, those being the light moving around and the textures changing from a sort of clean texture to a really grungy, rusted sort of texture. So without any further ado, let's get right into it. Start off, what we want to do, we'll double tap A, X, and delete everything, and then go from Blender Render to Cycles. And since I'm recording, it's going to take a second to figure out what it's doing. Nice. Okay. So if you guys haven't already, go down to the description and download the Blender assets folder. And then what we want to do, we will go into add a background image, add image, and then find where you've saved that folder. And what we want to do is open up the BioShock logo PNG, like so. And what we want to do here, we'll change the axes from all views to top. And what that's going to do, it's just going to save us time later when we add a camera. Because if we were to add a camera right now and go into that view, you'll see how we're getting like that distorted, squashed sort of BioShock logo. What it does when we change it here to from all axes to top is that just when we're looking from a top-down view, that's the only time we'll actually see the BioShock logo. So we'll do that right now. We'll go 5-7 on your numpad. And that will take us into a top-down orthographic view where we can see the BioShock logo. Cool. Now, if you guys have seen my previous tutorial of making an energy sword in Blender, then you'll be fairly familiar with what we're about to do. So if you get a plane by going Shift-A and getting a plane, what we want to do is go to the Modifiers tab, and we want to get a mirror modifier on the X-axis. Go into tab to go edit mode. We just want to drag to the edge and then kind of just match the top vertices with the sort of the top left hand corner over here. Now what we're going to do, like to make clipping, and we'll just select these two vertices and drag them right into the middle. And also, if you followed along in my energy sword tutorial, you know exactly what clipping does. For those of you that don't, what it's doing is it's stopping the geometry from being able to go way too far past the 3D origin point. So if we go clipping, drag it into the middle there, it's going to stop right at that 3D origin. Now all we want to do is we just want to line up these vertices, with the top and bottom, with it like so. And then we're going to get that nice curve in there by going Control R to add in loop cuts, and we want roughly 5. I find that works best. Want to do is now we'll just go around and select all those vertices and press H, and that's going to hide them. And the reason we want to do that is because we want to make a nice curve on the 5 vertices that are right there without affecting anything else. So if we press O on the keyboard and then select the middle vertice, press G and then Y, you'll see we get this area of effect. And what it's doing is if I drag this one in the middle up on the Y axis, it's going to do essentially the same for the other vertices in the area of in the radius or diameter or a circle in that area of effect. And you can use your mouse wheel to scale it up and down. So we just want to scale it up a bit and get it just so it's a nice smooth sort of thing like that. And then Alt-H to get the rest of it all back in there. And wow, for my first go, that's surprisingly pretty good. The last couple of times I tried to record this, I've had to go back and fiddle around with that, but that's quite good. All right, so we'll apply that mirror modifier now. Go back into tab, we'll go face select, and press A, and then Z, and then we're gonna press I. And what this is gonna do is it's essentially gonna make a copy of what we've already made and kind of make a smaller version of it inside of itself. which is a bit of a weird description because I don't know how to describe it properly, but that's the best I can do. So we'll just drag it inwards till we match it so that there's like a gap between the outside vertices, So these ones here and the vertices in the center here. Whoops. Yep, these ones. So we got those like that nice gap. So you'll notice we just drink of water. That's it. Okay, so you'll notice now we've got this part here. So select all that. We've got this part. What we want to do with this is extrude it upwards. And also, if you want to know how to select all of that, you hold down Alt and then click between two faces and it will select all of that. Press E to extrude, and then we just want to drag it up to a reasonable height. Somewhere around there looks nice. Cool. So that's looking very good. Yep. Alright, so we go 5.7, and what we're going to do now is get a camera. So if we go Shift A and we get a camera, we're going to do a little trick to get the camera to be looking from the view that we're looking at it from right now. So if we go Control, Alt, and 0, it brings the camera right into the view that we're looking at it from. And what we'll do, because at the moment it's a bit weird on its positioning, so we'll just fix that up and center it a little bit more. Actually, you know what, we'll do it a bit differently. We'll go, Shift S, and we'll go selection to cursor, and then we'll just go Shift F, S, and Shift, just so we can drag it out a bit. And there we go, our camera is perfectly centered and above the Bioshock logo now. All right, cool. So speaking of Bioshock, that's what we're missing from this logo at the moment. We've just got this nice like little sign almost. We need the Bioshock text. So what we do, luckily for us, you can go Shift A and actually just add text straight into Blender, which is an awesome feature. I love it. So we'll just go Tab, backspace it all, and then we want to spell out Bioshock in full caps. So you can just do that by holding down Shift as you type. And then what we'll do, we'll go into the text modifier. We want to center it. And that's looking quite nice right now, but there's one issue. And that being that we don't actually have the proper Bioshock text. So if we go to open that, and go find where you've saved your assets folder. And you want this Century Gothic bold, like so. So if we go back to a 5.7, and go Z for wireframe mode, and we'll scale this up. We'll scale it up to somewhere that you think looks nice. So we'll scale it, and then we can just start to move it around on different axes to get it to somewhere that you like. I think somewhere, yeah, that looks nice. All right, so I think a lot of you would pick up on the issue saying, well, hang on, why isn't the I and, you know, the O and the S and a couple of letters not lined up exactly? It's because I couldn't find the exact text for the Bioshock logo. So the closest one I found was the Century Gothic. And in the end result, it actually does look quite nice. And you really don't notice it once you've animated it and put all the textures and lighting it. It just looks like normal. Yeah, it looks really nice. So if you just ignore that, you'll be the only one that will really know that. If you show that to your mates or anything like that, and they know of the game, they really wouldn't normally pick up on the difference unless they're real like fanatics about minute detail and everything. So yeah, we've now got that, but you'll notice, like, if we deselect that, we can't actually see it. So we'll just go into wireframe, so we can select that again. And we want to go into the modifications here and change the extrusion value to a 0.04. And then we'll go 1.5 on the numpad, and we'll just slowly drag that up so the bottom of the text is meeting the bottom of the shield, I guess. It's like a shield that the text sits in. Cool. So if we select the Bioshock text, go Shift D, and then in the text value over here, the text modifier, we want to change the fill from both to none. And then change the extrusion value to a 0.03. And what this does, if you were to press G now and move it around, see we've got a nice outline of the text. And this is so we can get a kind of nice beveled effect on the outside of it. So if we just go over to the bevel here, we just want to change the bevel depth to a 0.003. I find that looks the nicest. So yeah, now we've got something that is looking a lot more like the actual BioShock logo. And I don't know why I did that. So yeah, that's looking much nicer. But we're still missing something. We're missing that little city down at the bottom there. Now, I don't want to endorse doing this, but just because it is such a long and tedious task to go through and actually model that city at the bottom, I'm going to save a lot of you a lot of time. And I've created an object file, and I'll show you how to put that in. But for those of you that are still new to Blender and you still want to learn how to do things, by all means, you can go ahead and go through and model that. Word of advice, if you do want to do any of these ones that have got like spherical sort of things, not spherical, but circular sort of parts to it, what you want to do is you want to get a circle, your vertices select mode, and then you just want to line it up best as possible. So that's like kind of a quarter. So if we were to cut that in half and then cut that into a quarter, delete all that, and then, you know, just kind of start to muck around with it from there. Yeah, I'll just do a very, very rough job of this. Extrude it down. Extrude it across. And then we'll just select between. Actually, no, what we'll do, grab that one. Extrude it just over there. And then what we'll do is, if we want to connect these two, we'll get the top one, get the bottom one, F, and that's going to create a face between the two. And yeah, that's my very rough job of making one of those. But yeah, like I said, anything with a sort of circular sort of aspect to it, you want to use that circle. But for the rest of us that are going to be really lazy and not model it, what we're going to do is we're going to go File, Import, and Wavefront Object. Now, if that's not appearing for you, quick fix, we go User Preferences, into the Add-ons tab, and we just want to scroll all the way down to right here. And if this isn't ticked, so if it looks like that, all you want to do, tick the box, Save User Settings, and close that down. File, User Preferences, File, Import, and now we can import a, I've lost it. Where'd it go? It's at the bottom here now. Okay, yeah, so then we can import a object. So once again, we just wanna go to the Assets folder, and we wanna get the Untitled Object. I forgot to give it an actual name. I might change that in the folders that you guys will be downloading. So it'll probably be called City Object for you guys. So just double click on that, and you'll see we've now got that nice city right at the bottom there. I did actually have to go through once and model all of that, and that's why I want to save you guys from doing that, because it was such a long thing to do. And if we just go into the material tab over here, we just want to remove the material. My bad that I forgot to remove the material when I created it as an object. But yeah, so right now we've got something that's starting to look pretty reminiscent of the actual BioShock logo. We've got the text, we've got the sort of shield, we've got the city, and it's all looking good. So this is going to be part one. I do seem to have a habit of breaking my tutorials up into three parts, but I just find it's easier than having to cram about, I don't know, this will probably take maybe an hour to make in total. So I just find it's better if I break it up into parts so you guys can take it at your own pace. So this one, we've just learned how to pretty much make the essential logo. Next tutorial, I'll be showing you how to materialize everything and texture it. And then in the third tutorial, I'll be showing you how to animate the lighting and the textures to change. So I hope you guys have enjoyed part one. If I'm smart enough, I will have a link on the screen right now to take you straight to part two. If not, then I'm sure you have the capabilities to go find it yourself. But I will strive to have that there for you in the final edited version. Anyway, guys, I hope you've enjoyed. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more Blender tutorials, and I'll see you in the next one.